welcome to my YouTube channel. I don't think I'm ever going to get over saying YouTube channel. Like, I feel like it's something that I've probably wanted to do for such a long time, but just haven't really had the nerve to. So I want to do this first video as a bit of introduction to who I am, why I'm here, and what on earth I'm talking about. So most of you that have found me or know me probably know me through my Instagram page. I've recently kind of had a bit of a rebrand, and I'm now CompletelyCarys on my Instagram, my Twitter, and obviously now my YouTube channel as well. Basically, my Instagram account started just under two years ago, August 2015. Long and short of it, basically, I've always been a size 8 to 10, pretty much through my late teens and my early 20s. And then I got in a relationship. And basically, in about 6 months' time, I'd passed my driving test, moved out of my family home, got my own place, and got a boyfriend. And within those 6 months, I managed to pile on 3 stone. You know the photographs of when you're sat by the beach or the swimming pool, and you see everybody else having the lovely photographs taken, and you want one as well? So I asked my boyfriend to take some photos of me, and I didn't see them until a couple of days after they'd been taken, basically. Oh my gosh, I was in for an absolute shock. I did not realise how much weight I had put on in 6 months. It was basically a domino effect, pretty much, of passing my driving test and not walking anywhere anymore. So I wasn't exercising, I wasn't walking as much as I used to. We got our own place together after my parents split up and I moved out of my family house. And we started ordering takeaways, and I basically just got a bit lazy, and before I knew it, I was gone from this size 8, size 10, to a size, I'm going to say 14, 16, but 14's probably being a bit kind. Like, the reality of it was I was pretty much a size 16. I was weighing over 13 and a half stone at this point. Yeah, I realised that I needed to do something, basically, after I saw those photos. So I went onto Instagram when I got back, probably about a month after I got back from Tunisia, and I came across Slimming World accounts. I don't do Slimming World anymore. I started on Slimming World basically because it was something that I saw was working for a lot of people my age, and people were talking about it on Instagram quite regularly, and everyone was praising it and saying how brilliant it was, and I thought, you know what, I'm going to give this a go. So I joined my local Slimming World group. I am not the biggest fan of Slimming World, I will be perfectly honest. I cannot badmouth it because it really helped me lose a good chunk of weight when I first started. But I didn't like the atmosphere and the whole idea of just sitting in a room and people clapping you for when you lose weight and kind of going, ah, oh, you maintained, or ah, oh, you gained a pound. Like, I really didn't enjoy that part of it. But anyway, I joined Slimming World, and pretty much after my first evening and my first class that I ever went to, I set up an Instagram account, and it all kind of went on from there. And my Instagram has been absolutely amazing. Like, it's given me so much motivation. I've made so many friends. So yeah, I did Slimming World from August 2015. That seems so long ago. August 2015 until February 2016. So I started Slimming World and was following their principles, and like I say, I mean, it really did help me lose weight. I lost, I think, half a stone within a month, and then I lost a stone maybe in about 2.5-3 months, and then I got to the point where I realised that my body shape wasn't changing. I was losing weight, but I was still, wobbly's not the right word, but I wasn't as toned as I wanted to be. And I'd gone from being, like I said, this size 8, size 10, that had always been quite trim, to suddenly kind of this bigger size that I wasn't really used to. So yeah, I started to realise that I actually needed to start exercising again. And I really enjoyed exercise when I was at school. Like, I was on the netball team, and did hockey and I really did enjoy sport when I was at school, but just after you leave school, you just don't really do it anymore. Like, is you kind of did it at school because you had to do it, and then when you leave, suddenly you're like, oh, I don't actually have to exercise anymore. Like I said, I used to walk a lot, but really apart from that, I didn't actually exercise much. But anyway, yeah, I signed up to my favourite thing in the world, which is Results with Lucy. So what most people don't know about me is I've actually done Results with Lucy before I signed up this time. I joined it back in 2012, 2013, when it first actually came out. It wasn't really to lose weight, it was just more because I wanted to stay fit. Anyway, there wasn't really the community that there is now with Results with Lucy. And back then I tried and I failed basically, and then not long after that was when all the weight piled on, and decided to join up in October 2015. And I started on the on-demand plan, and I absolutely love on-demand. Well, it was solo back then, but it's been upgraded recently to on-demand, and I absolutely loved it. It gave me a chance to kind of just do the workouts that I thought I could manage, and I could choose different levels of fitness. And anyway, I soon fell in love with Results with Lucy. Like, I am totally obsessed with it. It is my passion. I absolutely love it. It's not just about exercising for losing weight. I genuinely just love to exercise. The videos are so fun. The trainer's absolutely brilliant. Like, I just love everything about it. You can tell I love everything about it. Like, it's changed my life. So anyway, I started combining Slimming World and Results with Lucy, and the two went really, really well hand in hand. I used Slimming World to kind of limit me on the bad foods I was eating, so like the chocolates and the crisps and things like that. And then I used Results with Lucy to actually educate me about what food I was putting into my body. For me, the side of Slimming World that I don't enjoy is like the encouragement to eat artificial sweeteners and things like that. The things that are like sin and avocado, like half an avocado is 7 or 8 sins, but then you can have a mugshot for free. Like, things like that irritated me, so I started to steer towards the clean eating side of things more, whilst carrying on with my fitness and doing the workouts that I thought I could do and that I enjoyed doing. So I did this for about 3 months, and then January came around and I had my 24th birthday, which really seems like so long ago. Like, I'm 26 now, like, when did that come around? So yeah, I started basically the New Beginnings plan with Results with Lucy, and I haven't looked back since. Like, the structured plans are where it's at for me. Like, I absolutely love them. And I did 3 weeks of it before I went to Thailand, and my body shape just changed so much in 3 weeks. I put my all into it. I really like looked after what I was eating and what I was putting into my body. I cut out all the crap, and it really, really worked for me. I went to Thailand, and I was still weighing myself then. I was still at Slimming World and I weighed 10 stone 10, and I remember that figure in my head so clearly because I was like, oh, I'm only 10 pounds away from 10 stone, like the elusive 10 stone that I'd always wanted to be. I wanted to be a size 10 and I wanted to be 10 stone, because when I walked into Slimming World, someone told me I had to pick a number out of thin air and I had to get to that weight. I went to Thailand and I had the best time of my life, and I felt uncomfortable in my body. I had lost just over 2.5 stone. I'd gone from a size 16 down to a size 10, 12, and I still didn't feel good enough. And it's really hard to like admit that. I don't think I have probably admitted that since I've come back, actually. I still didn't feel good enough in my own skin, and that was, it's really hard. It's a horrible feeling when you've put so much work into something and then all of a sudden you kind of decide, actually, that's still not good enough. I got back and I finished New Beginnings, and oh my god, like, honestly, my whole body shape had changed so much. My progress photos that I posted when I'd finished it are like one of my proudest achievements. And when I got back from Thailand, I was carrying on with the plan, and I decided to boycott Slimming World. I decided that Slimming World wasn't for me. I didn't feel like weighing every week was the right thing for me. Like, I felt like the scales were trying to tell me that this number was enough, but really that number actually meant nothing to me. Like, I get on the scales and I just look at it and I think, well, actually, you're not showing me anything really that I still don't feel good in my body. Exercising makes me feel good in my body, but I'm putting on weight. And that's been one of probably the biggest battles I've overcome. So since I came back from Thailand, which was February, I have carried on results with Lucy, basically 120% pretty much. Like, I absolutely love it. Like, the structure plans work for me so well, and I use their style of eating. I use the 80-20 principle. I don't weigh. I sometimes measure, but most of the time I can't really be bothered. I just tend to go by how I feel in my clothes, in my skin, and in my body. So yeah, I left Slimming World and went to Results with Lucy. And then not long after that, I had a lovely phone call from Results with Lucy, and they'd seen that I'd been talking about them on social media for about 6 months. And they said, hey, like, we want some ambassadors. Like, we're looking at launching an ambassador scheme. Like, would you be interested in this? And, oh my God, like, I was so honored. Like, honestly, like, even to this day, for me, it's such an honor to be an ambassador for Results with Lucy. And it basically means that I'm there to offer guidance and support and just to help people, like, whether you're a complete newbie and you want to start a new plan, or whether you're somebody that's been with Results with Lucy since the beginning, or for 3 years, or for 2 years, or you've done one plan, or you've done 10 plans, and to just kind of, like, help people pick a plan, decide what's best for them, or go for, like, an on-demand structure, and basically just help people. And it's so satisfying. I've helped over 200 people at least start a journey. It's not necessarily a weight loss journey, but just a journey to a happier them, really. And that's something I'm really proud of and really passionate about as well. I'm still Results with Lucy. I absolutely love, like I said, I love them. My next journey from there, like, it's a really long process, this, and I think when people visit my account now, they see me as this woman that loves her body and enjoys exercising and enjoys eating well, but also likes the odd beer and a slice of cheesecake. Like, and I'm really lucky that I have a really good balance in my life, but it's not easy. Like, it really isn't easy. Like, when I was younger, I was bullied at school. It was really hard. Like, I was the new kid at school for, basically, when I was younger, I used to do, like, baby modelling. So I was in the Pampers adverts. I did, like, Toys R Us campaigns. I was on the front of Mother's Weekly. And I joined school late and was always the weird child. And as I'd grown up, like, little things that, like, people used to pick up on, and the bad things in society still, like, your eyebrows aren't the right shape, or your hair's not quite right, or you don't have straight hair, and things like this. And it was just little things that I used to get nitpicked at along the years, like, through school and whatnot. And I don't think I realised how much they got to me. And it wasn't until I put weight on, lost weight, and went through this, like, I don't want to call it a journey of self-discovery, but that's what it is. Like, you go through this process and you think, actually, I'm not that bad. Like, I spent so much of my life looking at photos and thinking, oh my God, I look so fat, delete that. Oh my God, look at the state of my face. Like, why am I saying these things to myself? Like, why am I saying them to myself? They are not nice things to say. Like, I wouldn't go out and say that to my best friend. Like, I wouldn't do that. So why do I think it's okay to say it to myself? It's not, basically. So my friend Gemma introduced me to a book, this book. This is The Goddess Revolution by Mel Wells, and I absolutely love this book. I will constantly talk about it. This and the combination of doing Results with Lucy and talking to the trainers like Cecilia and chatting with Lucy, like, people think that exercising and losing weight is all about looking good, but it's not. It's about feeling good and your mindset as well. And like I say, I used to pick my body apart for all the things that I hated. Like, my weight always used to go onto my legs, it still does, and onto my lower part of my stomach if I eat bad food. I've always been really self-conscious of my legs. And in the last year, a lot of things have happened, and in the grand scheme of things, I started to think, does it really matter if my legs wobble too much? Does it really matter if my tummy's a little bit jiggly and I've got a little love pouch? Like, in the grand scheme of things, do those things really matter in my life? The answer's no. And this is why I think, like, people say to me, oh, you're in such a good place, like, how do you do it? And the minute you start telling yourself that you're worthy and you're not a piece of shit and you're not fat, like, the minute you look in the mirror, and I mean, I still have off days now, right? So, like, like I say, I'm always being self-conscious of my legs and I live in black jeans. The minute I put blue jeans on, I still feel a bit squiffy. Like, I'm not sure if I can rock that look. But the minute I tell myself, actually, you look fit, shut up. Your mindset changes like that. Like, something in your head clicks and it's like, actually, yeah, you look really good. Like, you look fine, go out like that. Like, and it is all in our mind, but it's because society and the media and everything have put it in this in our heads that we need to look a certain way. And the minute you start rebelling against that and just working on yourself, for yourself, and loving yourself, you will just notice such a difference. Like, if you thought, even if it was just for 5 minutes every day, about something that you loved about yourself, within a week, within 2 weeks, within a month, you will notice such a difference. Like, for me, it was always baby steps. It was having the confidence to go and do something that I probably wouldn't have done before, or telling myself that I looked really good. And it seems big-headed and it seems vain, but who cares? Like, if that's what's going to help you get to that point, then that's brilliant. And it's little baby steps and reading The Goddess Revolution, which changed my mindset. Like, I really am in a good place now with just everything. Like, with my food, I have a good balance. My exercise, I exercise because I enjoy exercising, not because I feel like it's a necessity, not because I feel like I still need to lose weight. I mentioned earlier that with Slimming World, my lowest weight that I got down to was 10 stone 10. I know I weigh over 11 and a half stone at the moment. I put on some weight over Christmas when my dad got ill, and that is not a problem for me. Like, I am still perfectly happy with my body, even though in hindsight I'm probably about a stone heavier than my lightest. But it's different, like, because I know I'm doing everything right, for me. I know I'm exercising regularly, I know I'm eating as well as I can be when I need to be, I still enjoy the odd treat for my sanity. I know that I'm in a good place, and that's what works for me, and it is essentially finding what works for you. But that's my history and where I've come from. As the 2 years have gone on Instagram, I've gained lots of followers, which is absolutely, like, bizarre. Like, I remember when I got to my first 500 and I was like, oh my god, got to 500, and now I'm at 18,000 and I'm like, holy shit, that is crazy. Honestly, like, 18,000 people that are watching me, what I'm eating and what I'm exercising and what I'm talking about and when I'm talking about self-love and things like that. And to me, it's just incredible, like, just to have that, like, support behind me. And I'm so lucky that so many of the people that I've helped signed up to Results with Lucy and met through Slimming World when I first started that, and just through the last 2 years I've made so many good friends, and I've been lucky enough to meet up with quite a few of them and go to events. I've been to Results with Lucy HQ, and I've been to their winter party, and I've been to Weekends Away around the UK with loads of different people that I've met. And I've been really lucky. Like, it is expensive and I've spent so much money on it, but it has been so worth it for all the memories. Like, honestly, I lose my train of thought, like, so easily. I'm surprised that this is what I was worried about with YouTube, basically, was that I was gonna talk and talk and talk and then not remember what the whole point of it was. I know what it was. Basically, I've been obviously blogging on Instagram for 2 years now, and I've felt like it was time to try something different. And it wasn't until I went away the other weekend and I was talking to somebody that was a bit insecure about the way that they are, and I was talking about it and I was so passionate about it that it made me cry. And I realized, like, I genuinely really enjoy talking about this kind of stuff. And I got back and I spoke to my boyfriend and I said to him, like, oh, we had a really good weekend away. And then he said, why don't you start a YouTube channel? And I was like, well, like, for me, putting myself this out there to kind of all the people that have criticised me and made comments about me in the past, not just for the last 2 years, but for my whole life, like, going back to when I was at school, it terrifies the heck out of me. Like, I'm not joking, it freaks me out. But if I could help just one person by chatting to my camera, it is worth it. So that's pretty much how I got here, and it's mad to think that it's been 2 years now. It's a little bit insane, actually, and it scares me a bit that it's been 2 years and I've been doing this for 2 years, but it's really exciting at the same time. So yeah, YouTube channel. I enjoy talking about these things, And this channel is going to be about me talking about self-love, which is something I'm really passionate about. And that's about your body, your mind, your lifestyle, like everything. But yeah, it's going to be about health and fitness. I'll be talking about results with Lucy quite a lot because it's pretty much my life. I'm just going to be talking really at you, and I hope this doesn't get boring. Yeah, it's going to be a bit of everything, a bit like my Instagram. Like, I try to keep it real, and that's where the name comes from. Like, the one thing I've always promised through my Instagram journey is that I'm 100% honest about where I'm at, my headspace, my body, what I'm eating, what I'm doing. Like, I've pretty much like just put everything out there. I try to keep a bit of my personal life back, because at the end of the day, like, I need some of that for my sanity. But the name came from, I'm completely honest, I'm completely me, I'm completely Carys. So I hope that like resonates with you guys. So yeah, like, this is the first video, all about me, a little introduction to who I am. My second video, I don't really know what to do it on. So if anybody has any suggestions, if you comment below, and it would be really, really great if you can subscribe to my channel. I don't really know where the buttons are at the moment because I'm still getting to grips with all of this. But if you can subscribe to my channel, that would be absolutely brilliant. And yeah, the next video will be coming in a couple of weeks. I'm actually off on holiday 2 weeks yesterday. So less than 2 weeks time, yes. I'm going to Kuala Lumpur, I'm going to Bali, and I'm going to Gili Ti. So my second video, there might be a bit of a delay in it coming out. Hoping to do some vlogging whilst I'm out there. I've got my camera and my tripod, and we've got a little GoPro kind of thing, and I'm hoping to get some cool shots whilst we're out there. But yeah, brilliant. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe wherever the button is, and I'll see you next time.